guys, welcome back to our channel. I didn't say my channel. It's our channel when he's here. So this is brother-in-law Hank again.
Hey everybody.
For those who doesn't know him.
Yeah.
He comes on once a week and we do what? Rock and roll.
We do great rock music.
Yes.
Yes. That's the only reason I would get out of bed, come here, is to do some good rock music, you know? So
did you enjoy your Thanksgiving?
I did. It was good. Different.
Yeah.
You know, different.
It was different.
Yeah. Yours also? Or?
Yeah, we had a big bird.
I know, you fried that turkey.
Just the three.
Fried turkeys.
Three of us.
Really, really good.
I mean,
for us.
We haven't done four.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was like a fifth. They didn't have no more small bird left. We had to get a big one. And I don't like leftover turkey. I don't want no soup. I don't want no sandwiches. I don't want anything to do with turkey after one day.
Right.
I hope you guys had a good Thanksgiving.
Yeah, yeah. Those who celebrate, I know a lot of you responded to our little message that
I know,
you
like
know,
the UK,
all over the,
you know,
celebrate,
they don't celebrate Thanksgiving, but yeah, we do here. Did you do any shopping?
No.
Yesterday
no,
was Cyber Monday.
I know, and before that was Small Business Saturday, and before that was Black Friday, and
right,
then
Brown
was
Thursday,
something, right, and Spend Your Money Tuesday. You know, every day is something. So I don't know, but no, I
today is Taco Tuesday.
Is that what you're giving me? I hope some tacos. I can go for some tacos.
No, but we got wine. Every day is wine day.
This is how she gets me back here with a promise of wine.
Okay, you guys, get your wine ready. You know.
Salute everybody.
So now we're gonna go into a request, right?
We are gonna do a request.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna do actually, you know what? Before we go into it, I just wanted to give people an update. You know, we spoke a few weeks ago when Alex Trebek passed away.
Okay.
We spoke about Jeopardy. You know, we did a little
update. What is your life?
She hasn't even started drinking yet. She's talking silly. No, they, you know, initially what they had said was that Alex's last show was going to be Christmas.
Right.
You know, the last Jeopardy show with Alex Trebek hosting it was going to be Christmas.
Yeah.
So now they had they revamped the whole thing.
Right.
And what they're going to do is they're going to have a bunch of celebrity hosts for a while. I guess until they find out who's the perfect fit.
Is it Ken Jennings?
Right. So
okay.
So the first one that they're going to try out that's going to host is going to be Ken Jennings.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it's no surprise.
I think he's the best one.
Well, no surprise to anyone because
he's
got, you know, he's known as the best Jeopardy player ever. He, you know, won 74 shows in a row, all that stuff. But so he's going to start the week of January 11th.
Mm-hmm.
So what they're going to do now is they're going to, the week from December 21st to 28th, they're going to show repeats, what they're saying, some of Alex's best shows.
Okay.
And then on the week of the 4th, January 4th, that's going to be the last week of Alex Trebek. So it should be
instead of the 25th, it's not the 4th.
Right. So it should be Friday the 8th, which would be that last that Friday.
Mm.
That should be his last show, in case some of you are interested.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm going to be watching regardless.
Don't
but,
call you.
Yeah, so that's right. Well, Friday, yeah, at 7:30. But all those days, you know,
okay.
I'll be busy watching. But just wanted to update because we spoke about it. You know, greatest game show host of all time
in
the past recently.
Jeopardy.
Yeah. So anyway,
it's a lot of people are into Jeopardy.
Yeah, and since we spoke about it, and I heard the news a few days ago, I said, you know, let me at least bring it up. So, you know, all love to Alex, and may you rest in peace. And yeah, we'll move on. We'll go to a request. And somebody requested Kansas.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I saw Kansas, the request. I never saw the band live, unfortunately. But when I saw that, I jumped on it because that's one of those rock, classic rock bands, progressive rock bands.
I like them.
When there's like so much musically going on.
Yep.
And these guys were a typical classic rock band, you know. Again, in progressive, where there's keyboards, there's drums, there's like everything, and they somehow mix it up together with harmonies. I mean, it's just an incredible, they were an incredible band. And so I thought, you know what? Yeah, that's a great suggestion. And I figure we'll do Carry On Wayward Son, which is, I don't know if they're the biggest hit, because
it's their popular song.
It's a very popular
song.
Everybody
knows this song.
Everybody, yeah. This one was, for a couple of years, the most played song on FM radio.
Yeah,
like in the 95, 96, 97, I think it was like the most played song. I mean, you heard it everywhere.
And you hear it a lot in the movies too.
Yeah. All right, so anyway, so yeah, no, it's one of those great songs. So I thought, you know, we could start with that. And I know we tried a couple of live versions, and I think they got blocked.
No,
so
live version is no good.
Yeah. So
this is an official.
We'll do the official
studio,
video.
Studio, yeah, official.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right.
Yep. Yep.
So let's get to it.
Let's do it.
Let's go. Carry on, my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no
Butthead. What's that?
I feel like we look like Beavis and Butthead.
We're back in, just popping our heads back and forth. I'm Beavis.
I would be Butthead. I don't know which one is which, so.
Yeah, me neither. Yeah.
Yeah.
your stuff, huh?
I'm so happy.
Yeah.
A song that I know.
A great rock song that you know. Yeah, they've got a lot of airplay.
I mean, I don't know like the whole, you know, like song, you know, like I just know like right. little.
Right. No, yeah, this, like I said, it was the most played song for a couple of years, so everywhere.
But it sounds so good now, yeah. You know what I mean? Listening right. to it now, it's like, you know, because you've got like, I guess your ears are more mature and, you know, like,
you're
not listening, it's just listen to it kind of thing, you know?
Absolutely, like, absolutely. And even live, they sounded really great. We tried a couple of live versions that got blocked, so that's why we went with the studio. But live, they were tight.
Okay,
band.
There's a redheaded guy, right? That guy over there.
No, that's the cover. That's the album. That's just a drawing. But there were some different looking characters. You know, one was like huge and with a big beard, and you know, one looked like Hagrid from Harry Potter. I mean, the other guy that's
right, he's the redheaded guy, isn't he?
I don't know. I don't know. But they were all like huge and you know.
I was watching a live video, mm-hmm. and there was this redheaded guy with the red beard and everything.
Right, one of the guitar players.
Oh, he is. Yeah. He's not the singer.
Yeah. Okay. So, but yeah, no, there was a couple. I know one of them, I remember, with the overalls, huge dude with big hair. I mean, I don't know all the members' names. I know the singer was
Steve
Walsh,
but they're so good, though.
Yeah, no, they were great. They were absolutely great, and they have all these different instruments, and you know, they sound so good. You know, and that's what you know what they call progressive rock is when you take it and you know the chord progression. They change speed, they change sounds, and you know, like they were jamming, and then the part you like with the piano, you know, they bring it down, and then they bring it back up again.
I like this kind of music.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. No, there's a lot of this kind of music out there that you haven't heard. You've heard Dust in the Wind, I'm sure.
Oh that's my God, one of the most played songs. It doesn't get blocked because that's a beautiful one. Too.
Yeah, that's beautiful, you know, song. They're probably their biggest. I'm sure that's sold might more than this one. They have another song called Point of No Return, which is also a great, similar to this. Yeah. You know, great rock song, and then it takes it to different levels, and you know, it's an incredible song also. So they have a bunch of songs that, you know, that are really, really good. So, I'm glad at least you know some good music.
I know, you see?
Yeah, and I'm glad somebody...
Yeah, but songs like this, I mean, it played like in a pop station. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they crossed over, like right. It's not just strictly rock. Yeah. No, I agree.
It's a good song for, you know, everybody.
Yeah. So I'm glad you liked it. I'm glad that, and I honestly forget who it was that suggested it, but thank you so much because it's a great suggestion. And, you know, I enjoyed it. I hadn't seen, you know, I hadn't heard this song for a while, and when I saw this, hey, let's
And this is the first time I did this on my channel, this band.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Okay. It's came from my channel.
So it's a great song to do it with. Mm-hmm. There's a few more, you know, I'm sure. Yeah. Some big Kansas fans out there can probably even know more than the three or four we've mentioned here.
Yeah, I heard that they get, you know, a lot of their songs get blocked.
Well, it happened with the live versions that we tried.
All the
blocked,
good ones, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, well, maybe YouTube, maybe next year they'll do something different.
Yeah. loosening up the reins a little bit there, YouTube.
I know. Oh, it's not even them, though. It's just that there's the record label. Themselves. You know what I mean? Right. It's like they put a block on this.
What you're doing is really promoting their music,
exactly.
You know, bringing
We're
it to
a... Exactly. Making money. I don't make money on any of these videos that I do because they're all copyright.
Right. You're a starving artist?
I'm a starving, yes, artist. YouTube creator.
That's what she drinks.
Yeah, I can only afford
that's
wine.
Not even the cheese, just the wine. So.
All right, guys. I hope you like that. Thanks for hanging out with us.
Yeah, thanks for the suggestion. Thanks for hanging out. And if there's more suggestions for other cancer songs, we can try to do.
Even songs I love I love to hear them again. You know, that's like it's like listening to music with an old friend.
Boom. Or brother-in-law or sister-in-law.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely, guys. Thanks
so
much.
All right, guys. Make sure you like, subscribe, and
leave your comments below.
Bye.
Take care, everybody. Be safe.